birth were ready. I mean, you have two kids already, and girl, we're not ready for three. And when I say we, I mean me, especially me. I'm a kid myself, you keep lecturing and pestering me.
Remember when we pulled over to the side of the road, when I called my dad and then I cried, after I had just told him, holding me in your arms, I cried, thinking why's he not scolding me, letting everything out, I was trying to hold it.
I think that's about the time that I first was excited for, or excited for my baby's birth. Either then or the ultrasound, when I and you first seen that black and white image of her inside of you cursed. And then one day I was reading this book by Carl Sagan, when it comes to the part where he talks about the 4th century pagan, a mathematician, philosopher, maiden, brave and brazen, the face of ignorance when it had its safest haven. Her name was Hypatia, the perfect name for our girl, the perfect name for the perfect girl in this great little world. Then you know it's time, you've done this twice, it's labor for sure. They're saying that you're not ready, in 2 days we return.
They hook you up to that high monitor, baby machine, but we can't hear anything. This is crazy, it seems. They can't hear a little heart, we start making a scene. The doc says sorry for your loss, I hear the craziest scream. I hold you, console you, but everything I say will not bring our baby back. She's gone forever in a daze, in a dream. Heard she poses, curtain closes, too much pain in the scene. But what you felt in that moment, I couldn't claim to be keen.
This is what it sounds like when laughter dies. You look up at me and say she was supposed to have my eyes. Right there on the hospital bed, I collapsed and cried, hugging your stomach, loving what we had inside. I can't begin to imagine what it was like for you to have something you love more than life inside of you. United, you were tied to her, there were no tighter two. And right as you try to do what you must, she dies in you.
She's still inside of you, just try to do this fast. Pain will require her as she moves into the past. The silence that will bring is deafening with every last. I almost didn't hold her, how stupid is that? How?
Almost didn't hold my baby, but as a father, I would've regretted it, especially after I had to watch her emerge from you, giving birth to our silent daughter. I try, I wanna just be your knight in shining armor, but this thing should say birth, not death certificate. It's crazy how one word can change your whole world, isn't it? There's nothing I can say to take the pain away, but I know we'll have another rainy day.
Rainy day, rainy day, rainy day. Rainy day. All she needs is a heartbeat and we can just leave. And take our baby home, I almost start to believe. But the name, can you fill out this death certificate, please? I hear the melody of rain on the window, and look at what your hair is swimming, the wind blow. I'm standing in the rain, I'm kissing your lips slow. I tell you, mama, hold you and I'm never gonna let go. And to me, all she needs is to breathe. All she needs is a heartbeat. Whoa. I hear the melody of rain on the window. I love to watch your hair swimming.